Oh, just to let you guys know, in case you didn't know, Walgreens is really stocking up on the mask. I'll have the link in the description box below if you can't actually get out to a store. But this is what they look like. These are the surgical style masks. So you don't know if there's going to be like another resurgence of this thing or what's going to happen. So if you have extra points or anything that you want to use to get some of these, that would actually be a good idea. Okay, let's get started with this intermediate deal, and I just want to remind you two things. Number one, for this deal, we are using that coupon for $3 back in points when you spend $15. We're using that coupon for $3 back in points when you spend $15. Now, if you don't have that coupon, that is okay. You don't have to use that coupon. You can still do this deal, but if you have it, it's going to make this deal even better. That's the first thing I want to remind you. The second thing is this is an intermediate video, so I will be moving a little bit faster than I usually do. So for your first item, you want to get two of the Crest toothpaste, and we're looking at certain ones. We're getting the ones that are $2.99, and they have this promotion for $4 back in points when you buy two. So right here, we're getting the ones that are $2.99 and they're participating in this promotion for 4,000 points. That's $4 back in points when you buy two. There are only certain ones that are included in this promotion, so make sure you're looking at the right ones. Some of them are giving back different rewards, so you don't want to look at the wrong ones. Make sure you're looking at the ones that are $2.99 but also promising to give back 4,000 points. Okay, so get two of the Crest for $2.99, that equals $5.98. And once you have two for $5.98, we're gonna go ahead and clip that coupon on the Walgreens app for $4 off. Okay, we're getting two for $5.98. Clip that coupon for $4 off. That brings us down to pay $1.98 at the register, and we'll still get $4 back. But we're building a transaction. Remember, we're trying to get to $15 worth of stuff. So this is only $5.98 worth of stuff, so we have a few more things to get. Let's go. Now for our next item in this $15 transaction that we're building, we're going to be getting cookies. Most people love cookies, right? We're getting Chips Ahoy cookies. They are $2.99, but there's a coupon on the Walgreens app for $1 off when you buy one. So go ahead and get one Chips Ahoy. You can get any of the flavors that you want, any variety that you want, as long as they're $2.99, and then clip that coupon for $1 off on the Walgreens app. That brings you down to $1.99, but we're building a transaction. We want to get $15 worth of stuff. So we have our toothpaste, now we have our cookies. Let's keep building this transaction until we get to $15. So for our next item, we are coming down here to the Pringles. Pringles are on sale $4 for $5. They're $4 for $5. We're getting four, and we're clipping that coupon on the Walgreens app for $1 off when you buy four. Okay, they're $4 for $5. Clip the coupon for $1 off when you buy four, and that leaves you to pay $4 for four. So $4 for $4 with the coupon. We're almost done. We have one more item to get in this scenario. So for our last item for this transaction, we're getting the Puffs tissue. Puffs tissue is $1.24. That's a decent price for tissue. It's $1.24, but there's a coupon on the Walgreens app for 25 cents off. That brings this down to only 99 cents. So get one Puffs, clip that coupon for 25 cents off, and add it to your cart. Let's take a look at our cart all together and see what we have. This was the last thing that we actually needed for this $15 scenario. So let's put it all together and get ready to check out. All right, so this is what my cart is looking like. You can see I have the four Pringles, and we're using that coupon for $1 off when you buy four. I have two Crest, they're $2.99 each, and we're using that coupon for $4 off when you buy two. I have my Puffs, it's $1.24, and we're using our coupon for 50 cents off. And last but not least, I have the Chips Ahoy, $2.99 for Chips Ahoy, and we're using that coupon for $1 off when you buy one. Make sure you have all of your coupons, and most importantly, at least for me, I'm using that booster coupon for $3 back in points just for spending $15, and I have $15 worth of stuff in my cart. So I'm going to go check out. My total should be around $15.25 plus tax. And then I'm expecting to get $2 back from buying the Crest. And then I'm also expecting to get $3 back from that extra coupon that I have. Let's go ahead and check out and see what this all comes out to be. All right, so that transaction went perfectly. This is everything that I was able to get. Guys, oh my gosh, wait until I show you the receipt. Everything came out exactly like it was supposed to. So I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 items. And check it out. My total came out to $8.96 plus tax. You can see all of the coupons came off like they were supposed to. Chips Ahoy, Pringles, Puffs, and then right here where it says manufacturer e-coupon, that's MFG ECPN, that's what that means. $4 came off. Just, you know, it's kind of blurry on the receipt. You can't see it. But everything came off. My subtotal was $8.96 for 8 items. That is so amazing. Like, even if I didn't get anything back, I think $8 for 8 items at a place like Walgreens, I think that's a really great deal. Now, let's look at what I got back. This is going to be the wow factor. Check this out. Look, it says bonus points. You see right there? I got $7 back in points. Remember, we got $4 back from buying the Crest, so that's 4, and I had that bonus coupon that gave me $3 back in points, so that was a total of $7 back. I paid $8.96 plus tax and got $7 back. This deal was so amazing. I'm going to go spend my $7 now. I don't know what I'm going to spend it on, but I'm really excited. Do you guys understand what I'm saying? We spent $8.96 on this and I got $7 back. Listen, if you do this deal, this is amazing. Even if you don't have that $3 points coupon back, you will pay $8.96 plus tax and you will still get at least $4 back. You'll get $4 back. So you'll pay $8.96 and get $4 back, and you can turn around and use that $4 immediately on whatever you want in the store. The only restrictions are like postage stamps and like cigarettes and things like that, but you weren't trying to buy that anyway, okay? So go ahead and do this deal. With or without that points coupon, I think it's the bomb. I got $7 to spend, y'all, so I need to go ahead and spend that $7, so let's get started. Now, before I start spending that $7, I wanna go ahead and explain something that most people should know if you're intermediate or advanced in couponing. You should know this, but I know a lot of beginners watch this video, so I'm just gonna slide this in there for the beginners, and some intermediate people might forget, so this is gonna be your reminder. So we earned $7. Some people earned $4. But most of us earned $7. So I need to explain this. When you're spending your balance rewards points, when you go to the register and say, hey, I have points, I wanna use them, these are the increments that you can use them in. You can pay $1, $2, $3, $4, $5. Oh, but check it out. There's no $6, $7, $8, or $9. It skips from 5 all the way to 10, then to 20, then to 50. So we have $7, but we can't go to the register and say, I wanna pay with $7 in points. You have to use it in these intervals. 2 plus 5 is 7, right? So what I plan to do is go through the line and spend $2 of my dollars first. I'll get $2 worth of stuff. I'll go up to the register and I'll pay for it. And I say, hey, I want to use points, and the points will just pay for it. I won't have to pay anything. I'll use $2 in points to pay for it because we made 7. So I'm going to use 2 of it that way. Then I'm going to go back and get $5 worth of stuff. Go back through the line and say, hey, I want to use $5 in points and pay for it that way. 5 plus 2 is 7. I'll have used my $7, but I have to use it that way because there's no 7 on their redemption tier. So if I go up to the register with $7 worth of stuff at once, it's only going to let me use $5 because it doesn't let you go up until you hit 10, 20, or 50. So I hope that makes sense. I'm not going to break that down any further because, like I said, this is an intermediate video, but I did want to remind you, make sure if you earn $7, make sure that you're using it in $2 intervals and then a $5 interval. If you earn $4, you're good to go because $4 is on that list, so you can actually redeem for $4 worth of stuff. So let's start off spending the $2. I'm going to go ahead and spend the $2. So for my $2 transaction, guys, I'm right over here at the cookies. They're on sale for $1 this week. They have another pack that's $1, but this one is always $1. But this pack of cookies was a little bit bigger, and it was advertised in the ad for $1. And they even have a sugar-free version, which is really good to pass out to kids. So I'm going to go ahead and get 2 of the cookies for $2. Go to the register, use $2 of my points, and this should be completely free. Okay, so that transaction came out perfectly. I got the two cookies, and just like we talked about, I went ahead and just used points to pay. Do you see where it says my total was $2 and I redeemed $2 in points? So it came out to absolutely free. I didn't have to pay anything at all. Okay, so now that we spent the $2, that was easy peasy. Let's go ahead and spend the $5. For spending the $5, the first thing I'm gonna get is some dish detergent, because I stock up on this stuff, guys. Anytime I can get it for cheap, I get it for cheap. So the Dawn is 99 cents and the Palmolive is also 99 cents. I'm gonna go with the Palmolive Oxy. It looks a little bit bigger. That says 10 ounces. This one says 7 ounces. Yep, looks a little bit bigger, and I like Palmolive. It says 20% more, only 99 cents. So if you're doing what I'm doing, go ahead and pick up one of these for your $5 transaction. So next in my $5 transaction, I'm gonna go ahead and get an Arizona. These are the big jugs of Arizona. They definitely come in handy for just pouring them for everybody. Only $1.99 this week. The regular price in Walgreens is $3.29, but it's only $1.99 this week. So I'm gonna go ahead and get one of these to spend my $5, and I think it's a good item. So if you're doing what I'm doing, go ahead and grab one and just add it to your cart. Okay, so for the last item that I'm gonna spend my $5 on, I'm going with the Captain Crunch. It's $1.99. I think that's a good price. But if you're not into Captain Crunch, they also have the Life cereal. The original is $1.99 too, but I'm going with Captain Crunch. I haven't had it in a while, and this is kind of a treat yourself type thing, so I'm going to get one of these and put it in my cart. Okay, so this is what my cart is looking like for the $5 transaction. I'm pretty proud of this one. I have the Arizona, it's big. I have the cereal, and I have Palmolive. It comes out to just about $5, but tax will take me the rest of the way to $5. And when I get to the register, just like I did with the $2 cookies, I'm just going to say, hey, excuse me, can I pay with my points? They're going to say yes, of course, and I'll pay with points, and this should be free. Okay, so let's look at our $5 transaction. We had that $5 in points. Remember, we had a total of $7. We used two of it on the cookies. We broke it up because you can only redeem points in certain increments. So we used $2 of our $7 on the cookies. And then for the $5, we used it right here on Captain Crunch, Palmolive, and Arizona. So it came out to $5. Actually, it came out to $4.97 plus tax. And then it came out to $5.18 with tax, but that's my Florida tax. Your tax is going to be different. I used $5 in points, and I only had to pay the tax, which was 18 cents. So that came out pretty good. Let's look at everything that we got for the entire day. Okay, so check it out. This is everything that we were able to get for the entire day. Let's talk about our first transaction. For our first transaction, we got the Crest, the Pringles, all of that stuff. We got a big amount of stuff. We spent $15 total, but we got back $7 in points. And with the $7 that we got back in points, we went ahead and used those points to get everything else. So our total for the day was about $8.96 plus tax. So $8.96 plus tax for all of this. Guys, I don't know about you, but I think that was a really, really great deal. So if you want to do this deal, just follow the steps that I did. If you don't get back the $3 in points, that's okay. You'll just spend $3 more than we spent.